Today we're going to combine simple shapes with colourful gradients to create a fun cartoon-style monster face. We'll just concentrate on creating the main facial features which emerge from the background in this tutorial, but you can use the same techniques to illustrate almost anything. Keeping things simple not only helps make this tutorial good for beginners to get to grips with creating vector artwork in Illustrator, but this simplistic and stylized effect lends itself well to cool avatar graphics, product skins, or even stickers if you were to crop the artwork into a circle. So begin by creating a new document in Adobe Illustrator. I'm just going for the A4 preset, but with the units changed to pixels. To have a wide range of vibrant colours available, I'm using the RGB colour mode, but if you're creating your artwork for print use, CMYK would be the better option. We'll be using some effects such as outer glows and drop shadows, so one important step is to ensure the raster effects setting is at 300 ppi. So first head to the View menu and check that Smart Guides are enabled. Then select the Rectangle tool and clear out the default black stroke by clicking the None icon in the toolbar. Use the Smart Guides to align to the top left corner of the artboard, then drag out a rectangle to cover the entire area. Highlight the Fill Square in the toolbar, then click the default gradient in the gradient panel. Change the dropdown to Radial, and then double click the first little gradient marker to change the colour. Now this default gradient uses only black, so quickly apply a random swatch to bring up the R, G and B menus. Configure the first colour to a pale pink, such as 255, 214, 225. Edit the second gradient marker, giving it a vibrant pink colour of 213, 50, 232. Select the gradient tool from the toolbar, then extend the gradient size to the extent of the artboard. To avoid accidentally selecting this background, go to Object, Lock and Selection, or hit Command and 2 on your keyboard. Grab the Ellipse tool, then hold the Shift key while dragging out the shape to make a perfect circle. Edit the gradient colours to white, which is 255, 255, 255, to a light grey of 200, 200, 200. Select the gradient tool, then alter the flow so the gradient only changes to grey towards the edges of the circle shape. Activate the stroke from within the toolbar, then use the eyedropper to sample a colour from the background while holding the Shift key. Bump up the stroke weight to around 5 points, then change the alignment to the outside from within the stroke panel. Head to Effect, Stylize and Outer Glow, then configure the settings to Overlay, 100% Opacity and 30 pixel blur using the default black colour. Switch back to the Selection tool to stretch the circle out of shape slightly. Select the Ellipse tool again and draw a smaller circle within this white shape. Clear out the pink stroke. In the Gradient panel, edit the gradient marker colours to full cyan, so 0, 255, 255, then a mid blue of 40, 40, 180. Go to Effect, Stylize and Outer Glow, then change the settings to Multiply, 40% Opacity and 7 pixel blur. Make a duplicate of this shape by going to Edit Copy followed by Edit and Paste in Front, then scale down the shape slightly. If you haven't guessed already, the white shape will be the eyeball, the blue circle is the iris, and this smaller circle is going to be the pupil. Change the gradient colours to 70, 70, 70 and 30, 30, 30 to flow from a mid to a dark grey. Use the Ellipse tool to draw an extra circle that overlaps the pupil and the iris. Replace the fill with a flat white, then reduce the opacity to 30% to make a small highlight. Hold the Shift key to select the highlight, pupil and iris shapes, then hit Command and G or Control and G on Windows to group these elements. Add the eyeball to the selection, then hold the Alt key while dragging to make a copy of the entire eye. Rotate and position each one, then move the iris groups to change which direction the eyes are looking. This is where you can form the foundation of the expression, by tilting them inwards to make them angry, outwards to make them sad, or by pointing them in different directions to make them loony. Select the Pen tool, then click and drag a series of Bezier curves to form a mouth. The shape doesn't have to be symmetrical, so any irregularities don't matter too much as long as the path flows smoothly. You can edit the path using the Direct Selection tool to tweak the curves. Replace the fill colours to a deep red of 40-0-0 to an even deeper red of 60-0-0, then alter the shape and flow with the gradient tool. Select one of the eyeball shapes for a second to load its fill and stroke appearance, then reselect the mouth element. You'll notice that the previously used pink stroke colour is now selectable in the toolbar. Add it to the mouth shape stroke and edit the settings to 5 points and align to outside. Go to Effect, Stylize and Drop Shadow, then change the settings to Overlay, 40% Opacity, 0x Offset, 10y Offset, 5 pixel Blur, then change the colour to white. Grab the Ellipse tool and draw a shape over the mouth to represent a tongue. You can alter a shape's position before releasing the mouse using the space bar. Edit the gradient colours of this shape to a red of 16500 to 21000. Select this tongue shape along with the mouth by holding the Shift key, then activate the Shape Builder tool. Hold the Alt key while clicking the excess area of the tongue to trim it away. Click one of the eyeballs again to load its appearance, then select the Ellipse tool. Draw a circle to represent a tooth. Clear out the pink stroke, then change the gradient to Linear. Use the Gradient tool to alter the direction of the gradient and reset the flow back to the center. Use the Ellipse tool to draw a series of teeth that overlap the mouth along the top and bottom edges. Rearrange them more accurately with the Selection tool, then alter the gradient flows, particularly on the bottom set so the white is positioned towards the inside of the mouth. Shift and click all these shapes along with the mouth shape to add them all to the selection, then use the Shape Builder tool to trim away all the excesses. Add the tongue shape to the selection and group all the mouthpieces together before clicking in an empty area to deselect everything. Select the Ellipse tool and apply the pink swatch it has saved as a fill, then draw two ellipses as nostrils. Change the appearance settings to multiply at 10% and rotate and position each one. With the Ellipse tool still selected, change the fill to white, then hold the Shift key to draw a load of small circles in the empty background areas around the face. To easily select all these shapes, use the magic wand. This makes a selection of all the elements with the same appearance, but that also includes the two eyeball highlights, so hold the Command key while clicking those shapes to deselect them. Press Command and G to group this bunch of spots, then change the transparency settings to Overlay at 10% opacity. You can now fine-tune the facial layout by moving the eyes, nose and mouth around, which is made easier from us grouping those bunches of elements. The final result is a fun monster face illustration made from crisp vector shapes. The use of those subtle gradients and effects like the outer glow and drop shadows helps add some depth to the artwork and gives it a little more visual interest compared to completely flat colours. So I hope you have some fun creating your own monster characters. If you enjoyed this tutorial or learnt anything new, a thumbs up on the video would be really appreciated. Subscribe to the Spoon Graphics YouTube channel to be the first to check out my upcoming tutorials, or have a poke around at my website at spoon.graphics to find loads more tutorials and free resources. As always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one.